saying engineers in making, and the other one engineers on the go. So engineers in making are those whom we are training. These are the students. They are going to be engineers. So they are now engineers in making. And engineers on the go are those who are already engineers, who are professionals, who are serving in industries, who are either entrepreneurs by themselves, who have their own companies. So they are engineers on the go. Now, can all, each of these groups, engineer groups, can they, or the group in engineering profession, can they contribute equally in all these three eyes? Answer to me is no. So if we see innovation, the contribution that I can expect, or I believe can come, is from engineers in making. It's from the students. It is because, suppose if you see in like current situation also, most of the inventions are coming from NITs, IITs, and other institutes, engineering students. Some are coming from inborn like innovators, which are born innovators, like which have innovation in their blood. So these are the engineers in making. They will be driving innovation. From companies, we cannot expect much, because companies are driven by profitabilities and their strategy is different. Unless they see profit, they won't go for innovation. They will, but once an innovated product is available to them, they go for that product, they buy the product, they buy the patent, and they market it. So food innovation, the innovation from the very very basic level has to come from predominantly from students or engineers in making. When it comes to intervention, I would say it is both engineers in making and engineers on the go. Both can contribute and should contribute. And likewise, in introspection, I would say it is a stage where the engineers live their most of their lives, and then now they have enough to give back to the society. So here the students may not have much to contribute. So introspection will be mostly by those professionals. Now, if I now go into innovations during pandemic, you will see innovations by engineers in making abound in the areas of device development. You may have seen so many newspaper articles, so many news in TVs and media. There are so many things: touchless sanitizing, wash basins, door openers, sanitization tunnels, personal protective equipment, ventilators, safe swab collecting booths, app to monitor quarantine violations, cheaper testing kits, robotic units to serve isolation wards, and so many are there. Now, all these are essentially aimed at containing a specific pandemic caused by COVID-19, and they focus on a section of population that is either on the move, like us, who need to move, and or with those who are ill. So we are focusing on isolation wards, ventilators, and all these who are already sick, or we are focusing on those who need to move, need to go out for earning our living. But what about the golden ages in the pandemic? Like in the introductory speech, Mrs. Papuri said, like, home, like how to take care of these golden ages, who to think about them. So innovations for golden ages in the pandemic, if I want to focus, I would like to focus on making golden ages environment. If you remember, in their normal days, pre-pandemic situations, the normal circumstances, they feel the open sky in their daily course. So that open sky environment may not be possible in full extent, but to give some feel, we may try to devise something, we may try to innovate something so that they can feel that from the confinement of their homes. So it could be what? Like those who are not from technology background, they might find these terms a little bit tough to understand, but more or less these are widely used. So I believe you might have heard those terms at least somewhere in newspaper or TVs or in your WhatsApp or media, social media. So it is using virtual reality and augmented reality. So one option could be creating, it's just I thought it could be a innovation by an innovator. I just thought it could be one area where creating a three-dimensional simulated and composite environment of what? like of the street view of the neighborhood where the elderly people on day-to-day life strong, they visit on daily basis, they walk through, they walk around. So that, you all know that Google Street View app is there. So it's something like that. If you can kind of incorporate that street view through virtual reality and augmented reality in a device, and essentially facilitate interaction of actors in real time while virtually scrolling through the simulated neighborhood. That is what I mean to say. I didn't see this so far. That means you put on your virtual reality set and you feel that you are scrolling, and there may be silhouette. There may not be actual image of a person. It may be silhouette, which may be of your friend or of your, you know, people with whom you daily meet, and you connect them through your mobile or some other app. You talk to them, and you feel that you are scrolling with your friends in that virtual reality in your neighborhood while interacting over your phone, as if in a kind of, it's kind of a real life situation. So which you will be able to do from confinement to your home, and it will give a feel of what you used to do before the pandemic situation. Now, it could be building robotic devices. Too many robots are being devised or invented these days or built these days. Now, these robotic devices are known to, you know, engage with the users. Now, can we devise some robotic devices that may play with maybe some outdoor games or a small, say, bat and ball game or some, say, Gilli Danda game? So that kind of robotic devices which they can use in their lawns, like not going outside of their own periphery, within their boundary of their house. It could be in their terrace of their house or in the like small lawn. They can play some games with the robots, and that robotic devices can give them a sense of company. They can also be designed to delight them, to calm them down, to soothe them using, say, AI, their artificial intelligence and all this. Now, there could be some app-enabled physical gaming devices to facilitate playing games that they're used to with their regular playmates. Now, what I mean here, I didn't see this available. Like, I searched, but I couldn't find. But what I mean is, suppose a carom board or a game of cards. So take an example of carom board. So suppose if I have a carom board, which is sensor-based, which is connected to an app, and it has those strikers and those red and black and those small dice, and you strike them physically, you get the feel, you feel them, you strike them, and a similar board which is synchronized with this board on in your home, which is there with your other playmate in far away place, it could be in the neighborhood, he also get the same board, and there his board simulates the same positions which you like you kind of caused to happen by the strike of your finger. So that synchronization through app-enabled physical gaming devices, where you feel that you are playing with your carom board, you are feeling with you're playing with your chess, or you are playing with your pasha, or with your you know card games, where you actually throw your cards, and that card is simulated in a distant place where your playmate reciprocates. So it's kind of not like the common smartphone-based apps, gaming apps, which the golden ages may not be very competent to use. But if these are physical gaming devices, perhaps that may give more kind of feel, the more feeling of touch and play and more feeling of well-being. So this is some kind of innovation, some areas of innovation that I could think about. Similarly, the other innovations could be on the medical needs of the elderly or the golden ages. Now, here I can think about artificial intelligence, fuzzy logic, machine learning, sensor-based app devices. And there may be enough scope, and I believe there are, to devise or to design adaptable utilities focusing on ergonomics, understanding or taking into account physical limitations, and of course, cost effectiveness. For example, the toilet seats, the ubiquitous toilet seats. that is a special requirement, particularly for those who are suffering with arthritis. I see in my home with my mother. So it is really like a need. There are some seats or toilet seats available these days in the market, but they may not be as adaptable as a user may like to. So there is a great opportunity to design and to work on this area. Then assistive kitchenware, those who are particularly with arthritis, they find it difficult to hold the kitchenware, even to lift the spoon to feed them. Then with Alzheimer's, like those who are having Alzheimer's, they also have difficulties. So assistive kitchenware design, using, of course, those, you know, new technologies, artificial intelligence, fuzzy logic, so that could have great impact on serving these golden ages. The other thing that came to my mind is saving units. I see in my extended family, the elders are used to, the male elders are used to daily visit to their barbers, to the barber shop, to the salon, to get their shaves, to get their haircuts. But because of this pandemic situation, they can't do that. So they're helpless. Their faces having large beards, their hairs are untidy. When they look their face in front of their mirror, they feel a gloom, like they feel depressed, like they are not tidy. So that's these are small, like, you know, these are small aspects, but these make huge difference in the physical or mental well-being of these golden ages. So why not to devise some shaving units that could help them in this kind of situation? Then designing smart ramps and climbers for wheelchair users. So there are, of course, but there are scopes and like I believe to improve and get more user-friendly, more cost-effective versions of these devices. Similarly, cost-effective airbag type, belt type devices for accidental fall prevention. So it's again based on artificial intelligence. It could be based on machine learning or sensors. Like there are a few I could search, but again, there are problems with cost effectiveness. It's something like kind of just as in cars, in case of accidents, instantaneously the airbag comes into rescue. So here, if an elderly just gets to fall accidentally, the sensors that sense the danger and immediately, instantaneously, the airbag gets open and he or she gets some kind of relief or some kind of protection from the fall. Another idea could be app-based smart calling bells. Now, in smartphones, we have, you know, calling buttons, emergency buttons, all these are there. But what about these elderly people who are not, you know, tech savvy, who cannot use their mobiles or smartphones that efficiently? So in case of emergency, when they feel the need, how to call their relatives or the near ones? So if some of you might have used the calling bells, like a simple calling bell, which is left in the seat by the bedside, and when he or she needs it, he or she presses that bell and an alarm, a mechanical alarm or a digital alarm rings and the help arrives. Now, in this age of agility where people are on the move, it's very difficult in many cases for the family members to remain full time around the elderly people in home. So in those situations, if smart calling bells are, what I mean is, suppose it could be a physical device, just like a calling bell, but it will be connected to a unit which will be app-based and which will be, you know, net-enabled. And as soon as the golden ager or the elderly people just presses that ergonomically designed calling bell, the signal goes to the relatives wherever they are, and it goes to the health workers, to the neighbors, whosoever is set in that device. So that gives some kind of support system, that may give some kind of support system to the elderly in this kind of situations. Now, these are some of the innovations that I could think about. There are so many, scopes. And I think I will urge upon our engineers in the making, the students of the technical institutes, the design institutes, engineering institutes, to innovate and to put time to think about the need of the moment, need of the hour, and serve the society through their innovations. Now, next one was intervention. And there I said, both engineers in the go and engineers in the in making have scopes to contribute. So if I talk about engineers in the go, those who are professional engineers, I would say they can undertake activities to meet their CSR commitments, the corporate social responsibilities. Every company has got some kind of CSR commitments. So these engineers who are in profession, they can use that CSR commitment of their companies, and they can do, they can serve the society, they can serve the elderly. So how is it possible? There are, I have given some indications for they may organize safe and secured outing or meeting of the golden ages to make them enjoy the open sky environment. So it could be they can sponsor a bus, and they can maintain social distance, and they can just collect the golden ages from a neighborhood or from a society or from a community or from a village, and then take them for a outing by keeping the safety security as the prime concern. They can listen and they can try to gauge the difficulties and concerns that the golden ages feel and express. They can analyze these inputs and the device actions to find solutions to these problems. As CSR activities, they can also provide devices, gadgets, apps. They can facilitate their use. They can make the if they show their uses so that the golden ages can use them and reap the benefits of the technology and design. So here you know, it's not innovation. Innovation is already there. Somebody else is innovating. Some products are already there. But here, the engineers who are in profession, they are providing CSR services, and they are helping the golden ages to live through this pandemic. Those who are better off, some of them may have their own companies, they may donate themselves, or an engineer individually without going through his company. He, as a professional, he can donate devices, gadgets, apps, etc. to care homes or to golden ages in the community so that they are used during pandemic situation in particular, can bring about positive changes to the mental health of the golden ages. So it is kind of engineers who are already in the profession. Now, for engineers in making, the students, how can they intervene? So if I cite social internship of All India Council of Technical Education. In 2019 only, in their internship policy, they made provision for rural and social internship, wherein an undergraduate student may choose any of 15 suggestive activities. They gave a list of 15 suggestive activities. And one of them is to implement or develop technology solutions which will improve quality of life. So that is where we can take the golden ages problems into account. And we can urge our students to take up internships through EICT's rural social internship programs, and they can earn credits. See, if they devote, it said that if they devote 6 months and achieve the desired goal, long-term goal, that would fulfill the mandatory credit requirements for internship. So this is where we can leverage the AICT's guidelines or this internship guidelines policy to mobilize our students, to mobilize the engineers in making, to work for the society, work for the golden ages in particular. We may urge our students to undertake projects on interdisciplinary applications of engineering and technology and design for enriching mental health of golden ages. So they can take into they can combine the knowledges in different areas, in computer science, in information technology, in instrumentation engineering, in design, and they can combine this and they can undertake projects. We can encourage them to undertake these kind of projects with interdisciplinary applications for making effort to enrich the mental health or for solving the problems of golden ages during pandemic or in difficult times. We can also help remotely connect golden agers with their near and dear ones through video calling, online meeting apps, by using the network of students in different locations. What I am saying, like why I'm thinking about this, suppose in normal situation, an elderly person takes a public transport or his own transport and visits maybe a few kilometers or maybe hundreds of kilometers away, and he meets and talks to his near and dear ones. And again, that seeing is believing. Once that prospect is kind of stopped or limited because of pandemic, he cannot see. He can listen, but he cannot see. So if we can utilize the network of students, not necessarily of the same college, it could be across colleges. And suppose a golden ager is here, an elderly person is here in my house here, and he wants to talk to his relative who is sitting in somewhere else in South India, but he himself cannot use the smartphone because he is not tech savvy, or he doesn't have that facility with him because of economic reason, because of other reason. So if a student can help him see his near and dear ones through the student's app, the app in the student's mobile, but he connects by using his network through another student who lives nearby, where the near and dear ones of the golden ager lives. So that connection is possible if the students can mobilize their network and can do that one-to-one connection, facilitate that one-to-one connection. So here I'm not talking about golden agers in general, a group of golden agers. I'm talking about single contribution to a single person. But if that action gives a smile to the golden ager's face, that will give a great satisfaction, I'm sure, to the student. So I think that these are some of the interventions which I can think about. Now, when it comes to introspection, as I said earlier, the students may not have much opportunity. Here it is, who have accomplished their life's goals, who have kind of achieved positions, and who are in a position to give back to the society. So it can be that these kind of engineers can become angel investors or financiers for facilitating the incubation and development of innovation-driven entrepreneurial ventures, or which are aimed at enriching mental health of golden ages during pandemic. They can build care homes for golden ages. They can build medical facilities, just like hospital and home, for the needy, with focus on serving the golden ages during pandemic situations. They can establish charitable trusts, just as Tata's do, just as many other companies do, charitable trusts, NGOs, to specifically provide services through trained staff, through specialized equipment, who are dedicated to serve the golden ages or the elderly. So basically, these are where huge amount of money can be involved, and that can come from that introspection by the engineers. So that's the third area where an engineering professional can contribute. So innovation, intervention, and introspection. Now, here, the way ahead, I'll just conclude now.
Yes, sir. A few minutes more left for you, sir.
This is my last slide. So as individuals involved with engineering profession, we in different capacities pursuing the three I's, if you remember those three I's, innovation, intervention, and introspection, during our own journey of life, can strive to enrich the mental health of golden ages during pandemic. The cumulative efforts of all of us would surely be wonder in making these golden ages in our families and societies live the way they deserve to live, actively, gracefully, independently, happily, safely, and securely. If you remember, I use those terms in their normal situations that they do. So they deserve to live like this at all times, and in pandemic situations in particular, with lessening of psychological stresses and agony and improvement of general health through enrichment of their mental health. Let us begin. Thank you. So I'm done. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, Dr. Goswami, sir, for your in-depth sharing about what are the challenges these golden ages are facing, the world statistics about the golden ages, then the diversity of the composition worldwide, and also very interesting, this three eyes, which is a very new for all, I'm sure, those participants who are from health background, it will be a very new things for them. And also you have given us the insight into how things can be made easy, how things can be made possible. So I'm very sure all our participants, they are been immensely benefited from your talk. Thank you very much for your in-depth sharing. Thank you, sir. Krishna, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, am I audible, Krishna?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yeah, can we have the screen?
Yes, yes.
Can we have the screen? Can you? Yes. So we are going to invite our next eminent resource person, Dr. Unmona Borgohai Saikia, who is the principal cum nursing director of Asian Institute of Nursing Education. Presently, she is also the Dean of Nursing Faculty, Srimanta Shankaradeva University of Health Sciences. Krishna, can you play the slides for me? Can we have the slides, Krishna?
Just give me 1 minute.
Yes. Welcome, madam. Ma'am, please unmute yourself. Okay, I'll do from my side.
Okay, thank you. I'm here.
Yes, ma'am. Just give us few seconds. Few
you
seconds.
Can hear me, madam.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am, we can hear you.
How are you?
I'm fine, ma'am. Okay. Doing well. Thank you very much for joining us, ma'am.
Yeah, you can hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Absolutely. Well. It's good, ma'am.
Krishna, are you ready?
You can start, Papari.
Yes, yeah, just a minute, ma'am. Just a minute. Just give us 2 seconds time. Krishna, can you hear me? Yes.
It's coming up.
Yeah, ma'am. Please play it. Okay, I would like to give a introduction about Dr. Unmona Borgohai Saikia. Madam has completed her BS in Nursing from Regional College of Nursing and MS in Nursing from LT College, SNDT, Mumbai. She has obtained her PhD degree from Guwahati University and acquired postgraduate diploma in health and hospital management from IGNO New Delhi. Madam has also completed MSc Psychotherapy and Counseling from Institute of Psychotherapy and Management Sciences, Mumbai. Madam has also completed, please to the next slide, Krishna, please be with me. She has also completed ample of short-term certificate courses. Madam is the lead certified lead auditor for ISO 9000:2000 by BSI New Delhi. She has also completed CPQIH and NABH courses. She has been awarded many rewards and awards. Madam is the recipient of recognition and award from Assam Nursing Council for academic achievement on International Nurses Day 2011, and also she has received the Academic Award for Contribution in Research by GNRC in 2010. I'm very proud to mention that Madam's biography is enlisted in Directory of Women in Science in Asian Region by UNESCO. Next slide, please. Dr. Unmona has wide variety of experiences in nursing field and in related areas in healthcare organization. And she is simultaneously holding the and managing the position of nursing service head and academic head. She has initiated the culture of in-service nursing education in Assam, and Madam is conducting various research projects on women and health issues. I'm also proud to mention here that the first private nursing college, Asian Institute of Nursing Education, is established by Madam in 2004, and she is the recognized guide for PhD under Srimanta Shankaradeva University of Health Sciences, and presently there are 8 PhD students under her guideship. Please have to next slide. Madam has completed, Madam has many national and international paper presentation and publication to her credit. She is the founder president of Critical Care Society Assam chapter, founder member of Association of Nurse Executive India, president of SOMI Assam chapter, member of CAHO, founder executive member of AHPI Northeast chapter. Madam is also actively involved in different NGOs and CSR activities and is regularly organizing various social activities like health camp, roadshow, doing various programs to sensitize common people on mental health and through electronic medias. She is very passionate about adolescent and is involved in adolescent counseling. So, benefited. Thank you, ma'am. It's time to you for sharing your knowledge.
Okay. Thank you very much, Papori. I think
over to you, ma'am. Krishna, please share ma'am's screen.
Yeah. So by the time she's here, let me start.
Yes, ma'am.
You can start sharing also.
Yes, ma'am. You can.
On the very onset, I just would like to extend my deepest gratitude to the organizers, particularly Dr. Manushi Bujarborua and Papori, like always says, come Papori, Chaudhary, okay? You are very dear to me, so I'm just calling you very shortly. Anyway, I just wonder the initiative of two organizations, NEMCARE Institute and CIT. As I always say, the human been created by God. Healthcare professionals also been created by society to take care of the humanity. But healthcare professionals are paralyzed without engineers. However, you are bringing up this platform. I'm wondering the person from physics, chemistry, and civil engineers. And definitely it is going to be a very good discussion. Already Dr. Monmoy Goswami, HOD Civil Engineers of CIT, he already highlighted what are the infrastructures should be there, how we can make the golden age very comforting. And definitely we have learned a lot from him. And on this very onset, I extend my deepest gratitude also to both the director of the CIT and the NEMCARE for inviting me to this session. And I'm directly going to the topic without delaying much. Enrich the mental health of golden age during pandemic situations. The topic itself, it says that golden ages, it is a golden ages. That means they have a golden heart, they have a golden heart, health and heart both, and we have to enrich and maintain and nurture. So before going to my talk, I just would like to request you all just to show a clip, video clip. Next slide, please. Hope it will display the
technical inconvenience. I can play the video separately for it.
Yeah, please play the video.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you do it quickly?
Yes, ma'am.
By the time you get ready for that, I just would like to put the quotation in the next slide. It is there, of course. Aging is not lost youth, but a new stage of opportunity and strength. So, we see the aging means we should not take it in such a way like I am going to be restricted. No, not at all. I am going to add up with the experience that is important for me, important for us. We are going to accumulate experience for us. Okay, fine, the video is coming. Is it coming?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, all of you, please watch this. You may not be able to hear. Yes, we can go to the next slide, please.
Yes, ma'am.
All of you have seen this movie. This is the time of pandemic, corona pandemic. As in Assam, we also know this is a pandemic of the flood. And the scenery over here, by looking at this scenery, what comes to your mind? Are you having a pity feeling for them, for the lady that, oh my God, she is like that? Or how? You can go to the next slide and here you can be. So I'm just talking about the movie. So like, what is your feeling? All of you just feel. You no need to answer me after looking at this. Like, you know, there is two sides I can see. I can salute her. If I am at this age, if I am there, I'm proud to be C. I'm proud to be C. That means I also want to walk actively like her. Another part of it, if I am nearby her, I want to take care of her. Because she's 90 above, because she's walking for her daily bread and butter. This scenario, you just keep in your mind. And it's really making me very emotional in the very beginning itself. And I just would like to say over here, there are a group of people, you all are coming just to know how to take care of the elderly, golden age. Or also, I believe there are the people like, you know, you want to know how to grow old, to be have the golden age. So I'll try to cover up with my not with the book information, just of my very little short experience and observation of my lives that I'm going to talk over here. And there'll be nothing very scientific and very technical part over here. Just in the very beginning, I just would like to show you the classification of elderly. Of course, my previous speaker already spoke very well. Okay, here that is like, you know, young, old, middle, old, and old, old. So if we see about young old, what I say, you know, 60 to 74 years, person, if they are working in the organization, if he is working any organization, he is retiring. But if any organization keep that person, that will be their very excellent idea. And if many of them are going to join in some other organization, they recruit because they understand what is the experienced person. From the childhood till the age we complete our education, complete our service, we always run after something that we don't know for what we run. We don't realize what am I doing, how the things can be done much better way. Of course, we keep on doing, keep on thinking. But when you get the retirement from a regular duty, then our mind is open up like a parachute. And we always see the other like, okay, things can be done. We can be very stable a manager or advisor. So, like, you know, this is a very golden age, the first golden age starts, 62, 74. We can recruit the people, we can keep them busy. If they're not working in the organization, of course, we'll discuss later on in the about all this thing. Then coming to the middle age, Middle age, that is 75 to 84, sometimes it is little maybe difficult to come out for organization, but for the family, it is a great help for the grandchild to take care of or to nurture them, to help them to learn few things. And coming to the next group, 85 years and above, I say it is a more precious, if I say it is a goal, 60 above is the golden age, then the more pure and more precious, what we need to do? Yes, we can only take the advice and we have to take them in such a way, keep them in such a way, wrapping in a proper place. Okay, like the gold we keep in our box inside, right? So we have should not allow any dust to come or any air to come like that. So we have to take care of this age and time to time we have to take advice from them. So it is just a simple classification of this trick. And I have the next slide. So then we'll, next slide please. Then there is a types of aging. Okay, that is a classification, then types of aging. The types of aging called genetic aging, environmental aging, hormonal aging. So sometimes we see, oh, her grandmother was for living so long. Father also like that. Definitely you are also going to live long because of genes. And also there is a hormone we have, all of us, you know, the thyroid hormone and all, it help us to maintain our balance. And according to the age, if the parathyroid hormone increase and our, you know, we used to get the osteoporosis and all. So hormonal factor also automatically it comes, we can help it. But the second one I'm keeping to the last because we have to do many things with them. Environmental aging. So we have to take care environment like diet, physical activity, stress, all these things, you know, we can take care of it. If we can take care of it properly, then we can have the better health. Next slide, please. So we have to be very much alert about all these factors that can enhance our well-being or can give stress to our aging factor. I'm just quickly saying, what are the physiological and psychological needs? It is not only during the COVID. If I do not take nurture the person as a whole, we cannot wait then when the stress will come, we'll take care of. So I'm talking the entire things very common. So all of you know, for the people who are in the age, the elderly, sarcopenia with the increased weakness and when poor exercise tolerance, lean body mass replaced by fat with distribution of redistribution of fat, bone loss 30 to 35 years. So we, the ladies, need to have the calcium supplement, decreased ligament and tendon strength. So we get the pain in our knees and all. Then intervertical disc degeneration. So we get the pain in our back. So I'm just mentioning these common physical problems. Next. Common physical problems because the it also, like, you know, you can show the, all these points. Okay. It also gives us an unhappiness in our mind if we have that some mental problems. So coming to the mental changes, and it has been found in the research, most older adults report good mental health compared to the other age. But however, one in four older adults experience some mental health issues like depression, anxiety, schizophrenia, and dementia. Next, please. Next, please. And the physiological and physiological and psychological needs. Okay, these are the changes I said. What are the needs we have for the elderly? It is not for elderly, for all of us, of course, but physiological needs are sufficient nutritious foods. Sufficient nutritious. As I say, there are some hormonal changes. Metabolism also changes. We should know which are the nutrition they have to get, what according to his body chemicals that we, when we are aging, some of the blood tests we have to do once in a year at least. Depending on that, we have to give the supplements. And of course, clean clothing. It is not that I am young and handsome, I have to wear the handsome dress. It is my life up to the age of when I am living alive, you know, I have to wear in such a way I feel good, others feel good by looking at me. The comfortable housing, already been said by the previous speaker, like the, it should be spacious. We should, elderly people, we should keep in a very spacious room, well ventilated, well lighted room. because most of the time they spend in their room and they must have sound sleep. We need to take care of, okay? Now the generation is changing, thing is changing. We play the loud music, morning, evening does not make any difference. And we always see the movie, etc. But we have to be very careful. This person need to go to sleep and not in the early morning, not in the late evening, no music. So we have to give the comfort, good health and sanitation, occupational adjustment, adequate income, occupational adjustment, like accordingly the what occupation if he is doing in the office, if I'm inviting a senior citizen, oh, he's retired person, he's getting the pension over there, what is the benefit I have to be? I am inviting him to as an advisor, he can advise me, but I have to put him in a comfortable place where he feel comfort. Not that he has to climb many stairs and that cross road is very bad, it is not that. Okay, and at home also we have to ensure that what if he likes to walk, we have to create some comfort zone, we have to give some comfort tools so he gets busy with it. Then adequate income, okay, where the income will come if they are not working, but we the family members need to ensure that he has got sufficient money if he want to spend money by his own. Then leisure and good transportation service must be there. Coming to the psychological needs, satisfaction of various psychological needs and experiences, relative freedom from unpleasant tension and anxieties. So, we always think, what is there? The papa, what is there to think about? Like, you know, we are walking, we are doing our business, you be cool. Oh my God, he is not only thinking about himself, he is thinking about you all. Like, you know, we have to be very careful about not to create the environment that give anxiety to the elderly. Then free from financial burden, that he should not think about how am I going to get my medicine, okay? More love, affection, sympathy, and do not feel neglected, but respected and good companion. Never ever, you can go to the next slide. So we always, have to give importance and give respect and never ever negligence should come, you know. But however, during these critical issues during pandemic, okay, what are the issues may arise? The fear of death. It is not only elderly for everyone now, during this pandemic, everyone is having fear of death. Okay, but elderly also, it is there. It's not all, many of the people, they feel like countdown, like, oh, how many years I'm going to live? Okay, this pandemic will not leave me, I'm going to die, they used to think like that. Okay, so but the fear of death, when there are some critical situations, it is normal and unhealthy fear of death, two things. It is normal also. When there is a fear of death, I'll be very careful. I'll not go out, I'll wash my hand, I'll wear my mask every time, I'll be taking care of myself. But unhealthy fear of death, if that only I'm thinking and visualizing all the time, oh my God, I'm going to die, I may get affected, that thought is not right. And depression, okay, feeling very down, hopelessness feelings and all. Then anxiety, what will happen? What will happen for me? It's okay, but what will happen for my children? What will happen for my grandchildren? If my children lost their job, what will happen? If my grandchildren, they lose their study period, what will happen? So this gives anxiety. And there are some people, where we are going to get our food? From where we are going to have the income source? Okay, it is like that. Then also they have the insomnia. Okay, then adjustment disorder. So sudden change of these things, that they're not able to go to the fair, not able to go to the market every day. The elderly person go to the market to get milk. Okay, every morning he goes for walk, and how to adjust, how to balance, confusions. Now coming to the solutions, what is the solution? First and foremost solution, it is missed out in the slide, and we all have to listen to them. Listening heals the other person. Listening gives the comfort zone. But before that, I must tell over here itself. The person who is going to listen, he should have a good heart. He should have a good heart and neutral mind and listening empathetically, listening wholeheartedly. Then only will heal the other person. Okay, tell me, I'm busy with my computer. Okay, I'm busy with my the Ubin here. I'm listening to this. I'm listening with one ear, listening to you. Not like that. There is a time required. So first is listening. Then, whatever the issues for all this problem I am saying, first is listening. I will come to the soul consciousness later on. Then second, I want to say freedom. So when they are having all this problem, they are feeling all this problem, we have to give them some freedom. Freedom to do their activities by their own. Freedom to give their choices to you all. And you all also need to follow to some extent whatever they say. Okay, freedom to have their food and choice, okay? But we have to explain them what is important or what is like, you know, need to be done. Then if we are, has, I'm saying about the fear of death, a soul conscious, and just frankly speaking, you know, like, you know, for me, I don't have a fear of death at all. And I'm happy enough, like, you know, I'm happy enough that I'm living this many days. Okay, I'm very happy with it. I'm also happy if I have to die because I know I am born to die. So if I die also, I did not have the fear of death before also, but a couple of weeks back when I started doing meditation and a couple of months back also, I learned about the soul consciousness. And I'm so happy, like if I die, my body will be here, but my soul will be somewhere and I'm going to get the people again, like, you know, like, and what it will be, I'm not much concerned about also. I'm concerned about today. You know, I'm so happy that you all are around. You all are listening to me, you know, and I'm happy with it. And like, if there is no control of the death, but why should I think about it? I should not think about it. So if I think I'm a pure soul, I'll come back again over here, or I'll meet the people from the different part of the country, or whatever. So I'm not going to die. What will happen to me in the next step? I don't know. I don't have any control of it. So if you have the soul consciousness that you're not going to die, you know, you can think like that. And whatever is not under your control, there's no point of thinking. So then coming to the diet. Okay, it is very important during this pandemic, particularly diet, that to eat some particular, to avoid some particular food and to eat some appropriate diet. All of you already know like what is immunity boosting and all this thing, particularly who are the people in this platform, they already know about it. I don't want to talk about it, but it is very important. Diet is equally important, but a few more things about the diet, I'll talk in the next slide. And next, you can go to the next point. I'm going to talk about caring in detail in the next slide. Okay, so caring. Okay, when I'm going to talk about the caring, first caring of elders, the first thing is that what you have to think about, if any elders are here, like, you know, and the self-care is the most essential. Okay, now and always. We the human being, we are active. We are living when we can do our things by ourselves. I can brush my teeth, I can take care, I can take bath by myself, I can keep my room clean, hygiene. If I can prepare a cup of coffee, if I'm old, I'm saying, you know, a cup of coffee and all this thing, and cleaning my boundary clean as much as I can. First movie I have shown that yesterday, I have got it from the TV actually. I just opened the TV, I got it. I took the video and I put up the TV exactly. So like, that is, I'm still carrying that lady in my mind. So like, it is very important to take care of the self that I can anticipate from others. Okay, Papuri, is it all right? Okay.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Next. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Next is the coming to the family members' responsibilities. Okay, so during this time, what we need to do? Probably you all have the questions of that. With a family member, how to take care of the elders? I have a few tips just to how to take care for their mental health. Okay, So first and foremost, what we can do, each one of us, like, you know, we can sit and we can put off the TV, we can put off our computer once in a day in a particular moment, okay, and listen in our drawing room or the down on the sofa, whatever you can, okay? Okay, like grandpa, auntie, uncle, whatever, like you have at your family, a mother, father, okay? That you just tell me about your childhood story, how naughty you were in the school, okay? You just tell about your college days, okay? You've been teased by the boys, your grandma, you can ask, like, you know, that way you can start the day or at any time of the day, and automatically it will give a smile to them. That is the one tip I'm giving you. Second tip, like, you know, the technology. Without technology, we can't. And why we are pushing away our grandmother, grandfather? No, you don't know. They don't know. How come? They have come over so many lessons, so many experience, so many, like, you know, struggles in life. The simple machine is nothing for them, but they are very careful. They don't want to make mistakes. But the youngs, they use the mobile, they make mistakes, and they don't care about. But elderly, they are scared of taking this because they are scared of it. Anyway, so we can help them to get the Zoom app or any app, like, you know, with that, we can connect together. And if the family members are not nearby, their family members are not nearby who are here and there, only the child in America, only the child in the Bangalore or whatever it is, only the daughter here and there. And till now, I'm talking to the platform who are the people are in the little bit well-to-do or, like, you know, who have got all these gadgets and all these things, because we should think about another community also. I'll come next to it. For this group, at least we can help them to understand this. How old the person does not mind. You tease him, he will be liking or she'll be liking you so much for teasing the Zoom map and all this thing. And let them have fun. Let them see their friends and the old friends connect to them. It is so nice. Then next, another third point I would like to tell you, family responsibility. Dance and have some song. If you are at home, you dance along with your grandma or mother or father or mother-in-law, father-in-law, dance and song session, you must. Of course, we people from our side, we are having too much of inhibition. That should not be. We should come out of the inhibition, and we have to do that because it is essential. So if it is not possible, again, I'm saying, if you're not around, if you are not getting the people, the students are not there, you can connect through Zoom. Why I'm saying to dance, I don't want to give you the back pain to the elders. But the thing is that if you dance, actually it proves in the study, it improves the memory too. Okay, it is very nice. And the song to know, I don't think anyone is there who does not like song. Life is a song, even death is a song also we can make, okay? Because it is the natural changes, natural events, natural incidents, even death. So we can have a peaceful death, okay? So this is dance and song is very important, very nice for our lives. It should not be the let Bohag Bihu come, we'll be doing this. It is not like that. Don't change, I'm still not finished this slide. April to this time came, I don't know only, but we have to mentally, we have to be ready about it to create the environment. And then next point I want to say, the family can enforce the people to write story, to write poem and drawing and painting, okay? So what story? You will say, no, I don't know any story. I'm not a writer. Okay, the grandfather, you just write. Okay, papa, you write. Okay, dada, you write your stories, some of the stories. Okay, if you don't want to write, you tell the stories, I'll write for you. Okay, just say some poem, some good lines, like, you know, you can do that. And drawing and painting. If their drawing is not good also, you know, drawing and painting reflects their mind. And if they have the pent up tension and emotion, it will come out, you know, by drawing and painting. It is very, very, very nice. So it is channelized, the pent up tension and anxiety channelized, and it releases the mind, they feel very comfortable. So we can help them to do that. And of course, we can help, as already I said, we people think only the Google gave us everything. No, only the books give everything. Only we know, our grandfather don't know. That, but you use your grandparents to nurture your, take care of the grandchild. I'm sure he or she is going to be a very good human being, very good human being. That we have to. Even you can take the suggestion for each and everything. You know, few things we don't like because we have not born that way, but it doesn't match. But ultimately, it will be good effect on it. Okay, so that is one. Then next, coming to the I have just finished family responsibilities a little wider, I have said. And next point is social care. Papuri, you can remind me about that time, okay?
Ma'am, you can have 10 more minutes.
Oh my God, so many things to talk. okay, then social need, social care. We all are social being. So socializing is important for us, but current situation is restricting us. So we can make the connection with the people. We can, as I showed, a Zoom and all, we can have this, all this fun. But I just would like to tell one important thing. Emotion is very contagious. When we are making a call to someone, you should be careful to whom you are going to call. If the other person says, oh my God, COVID, I'm very scared, I may die, or what will happen, this and that, everybody is suffering, I also may suffer. No, never ever you talk to these people. I have an auntie who is in this webinar too, she's a very good soul. Even when I feel like talking to her, I'm a very limited person, with whom I make a call and I share the things. So I call to her and she always give me since they are Papuri, Mrs. Deepika Kaur. Okay, so she used to always give a very positive input to me. Here is the point come, how you can make a net. How you can make a net, like a mosquito net. You will get the air, but not the mosquito. So you have to create an aura. When you are receiving the information, you are receiving only dose. Okay, and particularly for elders also, when you are giving them to watch TV and all, you have to be very careful that you are not allowing to watch this TV all the time. It will be like some horror kind of the news itself. Okay, so that is about social care. Then coming to the spatial care for mentally vulnerable group. Here the things come. Okay, these are the things, it happens for everyone. But if there is a mentally vulnerable group, then what to do? We have to be very careful. First and foremost, we have to create an environment that they will know nothing is happened must. If we say, oh my God, what will happen? So many cases are going up and up and showing the TV. And we are saying, no, you pull down. Why you pull down? Nothing will happen to us. No, it's not going to help. Don't open the TV. Don't talk about all this thing. Okay? Yes, COVID is there. It is not going to harm to everyone. As we are taking precaution, nothing will happen. You have to be. So before the one important point we have to keep in our mind, before we take care of others, take care of your own soul and mind. It is very important. If I'm not that clear, if I'm not cool in my mind, I cannot take care of other person and I cannot understand the other person. Okay, coming to the next slide, please. I'll just talk about the, next slide. So when we are talking about this vulnerable group, and we have to continue about the medicines, whatever mentally who are taking some psychotic drugs, we have to keep administering, but we have to keep the environment as much as possible normal. Are you displaying the slide, please?
Ma'am, just a minute. Something had happened. We are doing it again.
Okay, fine. So next I'm going to do another thing. I'm going to give a scheme for you. As I said, many of you are very young, how you are going to grow old, that you have to take care of yourself. That is very important. So I'll give you a happy aging scheme. It is very important, as everywhere the scheme come, okay? A life insurance scheme and this and that all. So the small investment at early life double return at old age. Okay, for that, if they can see this scheme, that will be nice. Yes. Okay, come on, next. So first and foremost, as I say, happy aging scheme. And it's not that I'm not talking today that how you're going to take care of the old, how what you're going to do at the age of after 60 years, actually from the childhood you have to take care of. Okay, so first and foremost, when you are young enough or you can understand the things, first principle is that make a schedule. Make a schedule of your activities. Early morning, getting up, doing your things on time. I have my mentor, Sir Sri Jatin Hazarika, retired IAS 90 years plus. I have few mentors in my life. He is another one. And he always said that at early age, for as young as he was 5 years old, he was getting up early in the morning, 5 o'clock, taking bath, then only having the break. Then only he's going for the study. And always he pray. He did not know why he was praying from that age till then. Then he had breakfast. Then about the diet, I'll tell later on. But he has always a schedule like that. And when he was working as an advisor to the various chief ministers, he never carried the files back to home. He always goes to the office at 8:30 before the ministers come. So like, he always walk in the schedule. Okay, this is very, very important. Next, coming to the diet. Okay. Please, next diet. Diet here, that few things I'm saying, as Papuri said, few moments, I am just trying to speed up.
First, yes, one, ma'am. Is, yeah. Sorry to interrupt, ma'am. We have very less time remaining.
Amount, okay. Type, and vibe. Okay. Amount is, you have to, the Dalai Lama said, kom khaba, besi khaba, besi khaba, kom khaba. If you are eating too much of now at this age, then you are not going to live for longer time. If you are eating very judiciously, you are going to definitely live for a long time. Even that Hazarika sir, he said, even at his young age also, when he was in the school and college, he said, I only was having a rice plate, either at lunch or at dinner. So he was managing that way. So type of food, what type of food? What you eat, that you are. Okay, if you like the burger and all this thing, like, you know, what will happen? But you have to be very careful about it. Type of food, I don't talk much, but third thing is the vibe. Preparing the food. When you are preparing the food, there should be a lot of good vibrations and all. When you are buying and eating from the outside, there is always commercial aspects come. So it does not make, good input about it. Next, please. Next, please, next, please. Yeah, you can show the next also. One more, okay. Then next come the activity. I just put that the third scheme is activity. Activity means you might be walking in the office, you are walking at the home, or whatever it is. Your body demands need to work. Your parents have given a lot of money to you, does not mean you'll sit and eat. That you are sitting and eating, as I said, you're eating more and going to die very soon. And our body is heart is beating all the time. So it demands us to walk continuously. Our body system, if you do not work, then finish. So I don't say that the gym, only the go to the gym and like, you know, it is not. You have to be productive also. Just not sitting, going to the gym, I have got the money, I don't need to walk, I don't need to earn. No, it is not going to helpful for your both physical and mental health. So you have to be busy. And the fourth thing is that continuously maintain a relationship, that we have to be very careful about. The family relationship with your mother, father, wife, whatever it is, it is important. Then only we can be the good time. Then next is the point is that along with that, if you use the appropriate technology, of course, there'll be a bumper offer like you will have next slide in this investment. Next slide, please. Growing old is an art and satisfaction of achievement. Next slide. So we have to be very careful about. Okay, here I wanted to share some feelings. Miss Auntie Deepika, you are there. Do you want to share your feelings? Auntie Deepika? Actually, hello? I don't know since they are not. Actually, I have contacted the two persons as Jatin Hazarika sir and Deepika auntie, and both are the golden ager only, that they have said how they are taking so positively. Next slide. How they are taking that so positively, and particularly Deepika auntie is getting busy writing lot many poems, you know. So it is channelizing her stress to the great relief and the better life, in fact, I can say. Even Hazarika sir also, he is saying that I am trying to listen so many the Bengali song, Hindi song, etc., etc. Here the next slide is coming. CSR, already he mentioned about the community social responsibility. So here I want to focus you, a heart for the ones striving to survive and crying basics, crying for basics. So we are discussing about our own father, mother, grandmother, and we all are, I say, almost a well-to-do. Okay, but there are people, I have shown the slide in the very beginning. There are many people on the roadside, you know, they are not having food, they are homeless. So, but what we are doing now? So we should go beyond the boundary. We have to think of those people's mental health, and they are probably mentally better than us because they are striving to just how can I get food. They don't have anything to think about, but we are thinking, if I get the corona, what will happen? But they are not thinking of corona. They are not thinking of corona. They are thinking about the food. They are thinking about the, how to save their house. House is going due to the flood. Okay, so we people have to come forward. Okay, say we have to do some CSR. Never wait the flood to come that we are going to give donation. Come out now, find out and do the help. Next slide. So CSR responsibility should go beyond the boundary. The few more points I just want to say quickly, read, not no explanation. Amidst crisis, if someone is suffering at family, what to do? Accept the crisis, there is a storm, there is some damage. So I say to the elderly and to all of us, yes, there is a crisis, I have to accept. There is a fire, I have to accept. That's all. The fire will go one day and we'll be all right. Have the hope. Instead of saying elderly what to do, not to do, we must create an atmosphere, what I say, which keep them safe and healthy. Most importantly, we should not hide information or sharing in partial or both are wrong. We should not hide from the elders. Share clearly and give confidence along. Providing right food and comfort is necessary. Next slide, please. Next slide. Should not allow them to watch TV, as I say. We also have to seek opinion from them what to do that will give feeling of ownership. So you know what to do. Still you ask, Father, Papa, Ma, what should I do for this situation? What should I do? What else you want to buy me? How should I, you know? They also have something to say. Only you don't do you don't come up only these things and I'll do everything. No, it is not done. Many a time, young or old, middle, old, both, it's just they, you know, deny. I am strong enough. So you have to divert the things differently. Yes, you can do it, but the corona is not going to leave anyone. So we have to be very careful. That's why. Everyone is strong. Here we need to understand them and accept their feelings actually, and need to talk out with them. Next slide, please. So corona, I always say corona, there is a positive, every opposite values are complementary to each other. Even corona is a bliss for me, even I say. And in my life, I have never realized how important the meditation and all, like, you know, it has given me to learn to see inside me. With two eyes, I was only seeing around whole life, but now I can see my deeper inside. I'm not going to talk much about it. And I just feel that corona is also bliss, and as whole world is making clean, okay, noise-free, pollution-free, obviously, but there are a few things we are struggling, we'll overcome one day. Next slide. Nothing in life has meaning except the meaning we give it, Anthony Robbins said. In our life, what is happening? Oh my God, corona will happen, but nothing will happen. Just to tell you, you know, a couple of days back, my husband is diagnosed COVID and he hospitalized. And then my test is done, yet I need to get my results back. But I'm cool. I'm just getting involved with my work. If it happens, it's okay. I'm fine now. That's all great. But if I think what will happen to me, what will you keep on thinking, and I'll definitely go for depression. So I'm giving meaning to it. I'm alive. I can walk it now. I'm walking. I'm getting involved. So try to give meaning to the life. Next slide, please. So it is very important. And all this, next slide, all these quotations are been made by the great people, are been, they have learned many lessons in their life. They have overcome many dangerous struggles, then only they make the quote. When we are reading the quote, just not only liking the quote, we have to live with the quote, we have to accept with the quote. Next is, what you focus on, expand on, and when you focus on the goodness in your life, you create more of it. Yes, I experimented it, I realized it. You think good, good thing will happen. It will turn in the fraction of second, you know, and what we need to do for it, appreciate everything. In the morning, oh my God, I have got a lovely morning today. And you have to just keep on appreciating. Even the dangers comes to my life, I appreciate. Okay, what is supposed to happen, just happen. I know what to be done, not to happen the same type of thing next time. I appreciate the struggles when it comes to me. I love it. Okay, I love it because I learned a lesson to not to do that next time. Then another quotation is, there is no problem outside of you that is superior to power within. This is very important. And you have to think deep and you have to believe yourself that I'll overcome one day. That is number one. Sometimes it happens, no, my God, I can't live with it. Definitely everyone have your own God. Live to the God. Okay? All of you know Draupadi Bastu Haram? Probably, Papari, you know the story? Okay? Yes or no, Papari?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, I'm there.
What happened at the end, at that Bastu Haram? You know? At last, what she did?
She has surrendered to God.
She surrendered to God. She left her hand. She removed her pallu. She left her pallu. What will happen to me? But at the time, she prayed to God, Lord Krishna. And Lord Krishna helped. So if we have the problems such like that, I cannot manage, I cannot do it, just leave it, just surrender. What will happen? Okay? So your power, definitely God will help you at this moment. But you have to believe. If you have doubt, 50-50, it will, the result may come 50-50. Okay, next slide, please. Next slide, please. Okay,
I think
next slide. Yeah, this one, a smile one. Okay. So now I just want to give the exercise, one last exercise I want to prescribe to you all, that is the smile. All of you, please smile. That's just like a lock, you know, just next to next. When you are putting next place in the same slide. So yes. When you're taking a lock, just turn right and left. When you are turning right, it is getting locked. When you are turning left, it is getting loose, open. So our smile, it is just like that. When you are wearing a smile, you know, little bit change of our face and it makes our relax. And you all look like BB when you smile. All of you do this exercise at home and you try to even smile artificially, automatically you'll get the smile from other side and you'll be enriched with it. Next slide, please. Next slide. And then as Papuri said, there are some research scholars. I have got some topic for them. They can do the study. Research on music and dance therapy to improve the memory and happiness of elderly. Research on teaching and guiding the in use of technology for senior citizens for their satisfaction and happiness and comfort. Study on challenges and opportunity in their lives without technology among senior citizens. Study on needs of elderly, on comparative study, urban and rural. And here I have written the life stories. Okay, we always, when we are going to the kitchen, we have a cookbook. We follow this, right? And only we have the great men, few books that we know their story, their biography. But in our own family, in our own community, how many biography we have? So I'll be requesting all the family, they should have the recording of their life stories of grandfather, grandmother. So then what kind of problem they have underwent, what kind of challenges they had, what kind of art and culture they had, you know, what kind of their ability they have, all will be knowing. So every house, they should have a journal. It's not their smoronika, moronar homoyet smoronika nohoy. GI থকা কালতে তেওঁলোকৰ গুটি বস্তুখিনি কালেক্ট কৰি ইফ উই কেন কিপ ইট উই কেন ইউজ ফৰ আৱাৰ চিলড্ৰেন নেক্সট স্লাইড প্লিজ নেক্সট স্লাইড প্লিজ সো That's all from my side as Papori was pushing me hard to finish it. But there are two very short movies if Papori allow you all to watch.
Yeah, ma'am. Actually, we are running short of time.
Okay, fine then. Yeah. Thank you.
Give some time, please, only for those.
Oh, okay, okay. We can at least play one movie. Krishna, yeah. Can you play one movie?
Yes, ma'am. Please give me a few seconds, ma'am.
It is only 2 minutes and 3 minutes, both movie. Total okay. Come around 6 or 7
okay,
minutes.
Ma'am. Okay, ma'am. We'll try. We'll try to accommodate.
And what did you feel about the first movie, Papori?
That is wonderful, ma'am. No words to say because what she has done, she has taught us a lesson that at the age of 90 or above 90 also, we can live happily. We can
I salute her. I want all of us to be active like that. Exactly. And also we have to come forward to help them. She said she had daughters only. My God, no son. How sad to hear that we are daughters. Anyway, she's proud enough to earn by herself, but we should be sensitive enough to take care of her too.
Definitely.
So this is a very much positive side I think we should take. And I just would like to say, like from the to grow old and to be goal, and we have to take care from the very beginning. Goal only will be goal. Silver cannot turn in between, you know, we cannot make it goal. So from the very early age, we have to take care of our health and our children and to everyone. And I think it is not sufficiently, could not cover up all this thing. In future, if we have time, we'll talk more about this. Papari?
Okay, definitely. Yeah, ma'am. Video is getting played.
Go to play.
Krishna, go to the play option. Ma'am, actually, there is some network issue.
Yes, can I have the next one also, please?
Yeah, we'll try, ma'am. Krishna, please play the next one.
Everyone is getting the message, but the young also, how can take care of the elderly? It is we have to create an attitude and emotional bonding. It is very, very important to create an emotional bonding. We have to teach our children too, just to understand the situation. Second one, if you can, it will be a...
Yeah, ma'am, we are trying.
Thank you so much for giving me the time.
It's coming.
अबे ये कौन सी
लिस्ट मेरा ला यार वो मेरी है
दिखा 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 लिस्ट भाई देख finally have to study
ला यार उसे छोड़ यार
finally have to study
हाँ यार मैं आज से पढ़ना स्टार्ट कर रहा हूँ अच्छा फोकस कर उसे
बोल क्या रहा देख रो जरा देखें तो क्या पढ़ना है बर्नार्ड केमिस्ट्री सेकंड चैप्टर भाई केमिस्ट्री में 22 चैप्टर है आपको सेकंड चैप्टर
ठीक है हो जाएगा
तेरा कल्याण कल पेपर
है अपना देख यार तू
15 मिनट ब्रेक टॉक टू ने पीपे
यार वापस कर यार वो मेरी है
ना शाम तक
और अलग पास कर लूंगा पढ़े स्लाइड
लगा चला फास्ट फॉरवर्ड कर दिया
अलग मान अलग
आप बस ये दादाजी आप बस करने को कुछ है नहीं क्या हमारे पास इतनी टेंशन है पता नहीं करके एग्जाम कर जाओ
So here we got very restless for a single minute. So every old days they spend time like this, you know, like we have to understand and appreciate. Just to add, it will be incomplete mean sharing. As I'm staying with my mother-in-law, you know, the couple of days back when there is a lockdown started, when the lockdown again starts, supposed to be re-lockdown again, she was quite happy with a big smile. She said, oh, nice that you will be at home again. And when I go down like to talk with her, she even stopped eating food. She, from the deep sleep, she get up, she said, food is not important for me, talking is important because I need someone to talk. Even if we have a robot to talk also, it will do because without talking, I cannot stand. So I feel so emotional when she say, I need a person to talk. Even one day she did not have her lunch. So like, the time is very important, very precious. So we must give the time to them. Thank you very much for my side. If anything you have, Papari, that's all.
Over to you, Madashi. Please unmute. Manashi, please unmute.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. It's a wonderful speech. There's no word actually speechless totally. So
I don't know I could do justice or not, but one thing, another thing I want to say, that day when I had a talk with you, I was finding you such a stable lady. And thank you so much that allowing me to get your connection. Thank you.
my great pleasure, ma'am. And definitely you shall do some work in this area again in the near future with your blessing. Okay, thank you very much. So we may move to the end of our program. And may I request our registrar, ma'am, Soitali Brahmo, to give her valuable words about the program, and please give the vote of thanks.
Ma'am, please unmute. Soitali, ma'am, please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, please unmute your microphone. Your voice is not coming. Yes, ma'am.
It's okay now?
Yeah,
ma'am. It's okay? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The whole, both the speakers, it's a really wonderful madam. This was the first time I got to know you. You were amazing, amazing, ma'am. I would like to hear a lot about, to know a lot about the program, a lot about what your work you are doing. These are all our priority, and it will stay in the hearts of CITians forever. Now, as a part of, like Dr. Mansi have given me the to say as for the vote of thanks, I would just like to thank our honorable directors of both the institution, Professor Dev Kumar Chakravarti and Dr. Hitesh Borua, director of NEMCARE Group of Institutions. All the directors and professors, those who were present in the webinar session, and mostly our participants over here. So on behalf of the organizing committee, I have been asked to speak a few words about this session and to give a vote of thanks. So first of all, with lot of love and gratitude, I would request and from the whole of CIT family, I would like to wish both the speakers, Dr. Unmana Borgohai Soikia and our very own Professor Manomoy Goswami for sparing their invaluable time to in this occasion and to grace this occasion with their enlightening talks and their views, and especially Professor Manomoy when he spoke about the three I's, which are very much important and necessary for the days to come. And madam, as I told you, Rao, you were really amazing. And we would like to hear a lot about you in the future. And ma'am, like when I was in the screen, I was seeing the comments from the participants which were coming. And they were like, it was really like good. Everybody was telling that it was very lively. We didn't have a single moment to take out a earphone or we never thought we should have a cup of tea to get away from our boringness. It was really amazing, ma'am. Both the speak up so well. And we have got a lot of participants this time also, like from all over the country. And thank you, dear participant. Thank you for sharing your time with us, giving your valuable feedbacks through our chats over here. We'll keep in mind, if we have anything else, you can just write in on there and we will try to do more. And thank you, NEMCARE Group of Institutions, for associating with CIT. And we look forward for many of these corporations and coordination in the days to come. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Keep smiling, all of you. Thank you.
I just want to say there is one question. Okay, Krishna, can we have the question? There is one question.
Yes, ma'am. One question is there asked by R.L. Hota, sir, from CIT, I guess. Sir has asked that why are the people of the age group more than 60 called golden ager? That is the question.
Okay.
Why are the people of the age group more than 60 called as golden ager?
Ma'am, please unmute. Ma'am, please unmute yourself. Okay. Yes, ma'am, you're audible now.
Actually, as we know, the COVID affects in the respiratory system, lungs. Both the young and old, young also not fully grown, the lungs, and so also the adult or the old age, that the capacity of lungs comes down gradually. So, and this is such a serious disease, directly affecting the respiratory system, and so it may, any danger may occur because suppose when you get some problem and difficulty and ultimately like it affects in the breathing, then person collapse, right? But it is the disease directly affecting the respiratory system. So the person may collapse anytime if they do not have the sufficient lungs capacity. So that's why.
Thank Krishna? You,
yes, Krishna?
Is the question about golden age?
Yeah, I think so. It was the question.
I said about the age, both the young and old.
Yeah, ma'am. Sir has asked why the above 60 people, I mean above that's 60 group are called golden age. Golden age. Okay, okay.
Yeah. Yes, Papuri, I say the both the age, but the young age does not develop, but the old age, that the capacity comes down.
Okay.
That's why.
Okay. Dr. Monomoy Goswami, sir, would you like to take this question again? Thank you, ma'am. Sir, please unmute yourself.
Hello. Yes. Can you hear?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Well, it brings me to remember a kind of, you know, a document where a humorist, his name is... let me just see. Joe Guilvey. So what he said, like he, by humor, he tried to explain what parks a golden ager has and why he thinks that he has like a golden opportunity to leave this age. So I'll just read out a few sentences when he says, in this age, the kidnappers are not very interested in you. In a hostess situation, you are likely to be released first. Life is too short to dance with ugly man. You may be getting older, but you may refuse to grow up. People call at 9 p.m. and ask, did I wake you up? Things you buy now won't wear out. You can eat super at 4 o'clock. You enjoy hearing about other people's operations. You get into heated arguments about pension plans. It is okay to use your riding lawnmower for transportation. No one expects you to run anywhere. You don't have to get anywhere on time. Your trips to the bank are no longer important. You no longer have to appear as a fashion plate. You no longer try to hold your stomach in, no matter who walks into your room. You have found it's not easy being perfect, but somebody has to do it. Your supply of brain cells is finally down to manageable size. Your investment in health insurance is finally beginning to pay off. There is nothing left to learn the hard way. Your joints are more accurate meteorologists than the National Weather Service. You have learned to enjoy a really good slice of bread. So there are many such points that he mentioned. So these are some of the real life, you know, terms which make a golden ager feel that he is really living his time. So that's why I believe that the ones who retire beyond the age of 66 are very right to tell them golden agers, and for us also to believe that they are indeed golden agers. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay, with this, we have come to the end of this program, and we are looking forward to hear you more from both our eminent speakers. We would like to hear more from you. And thank you, CIT Kokrajhar, all the members from CIT Kokrajhar, Director Sir, Register Ma'am, for giving us this opportunity to hold this webinar in a joint manner. So we'll be looking forward to have more sessions, more work for the community people in a joint venture. Thank you so much. Once again, I would like to say thank you, Papuri. To all the participants. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Papuri. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. And namaskar to you all. One announcement I want to make.
Yes,
one announcement I want to make for the participants. The feedback link is provided in the chat box and it will be valid till midnight today. So kindly submit your feedback to receive your e-certificate. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.